My name's Geoff Butcher, but I've had Parkinson's disease now for about 13 years. One of the animals most used in research in Parkinson's is marmosets, and we're now going to go into an animal facility and talk to a scientist.
The marmosets here were all bred in captivity, and following treatment, they exhibit the symptoms of Parkinson's disease. We've not shown the scientist because of the small risk he faces from those opposed to the use of animals in research.
What is it you do here? Why are you using marmosets?
What we're doing is we're looking at a Parkinson's disease. We use a drug called MPTP to create the Parkinson's type of lesion. Some drug abusers in California in the 1980s were using a synthetic heroin, and a number of young adults were turning up at clinics with all the symptoms of Parkinson's disease.
The drug users had taken heroin contaminated with a chemical called MPTP, and it was the MPTP that had created the brain damage that led to the Parkinson-like symptoms. The realisation that MPTP could cause such specific damage to the brain has led to it being used as a research tool.
Did those young people recover, or were they had to be treated?
They had to be treated. They were responsive to L-DOPA, and they remained in that state.
And what you're hoping to do in the actual research here is what, develop new drugs? Or?
We are looking at developing new drugs. There are some very good drugs for the treatment of Parkinson's disease, but most of them have drawbacks when patients develop adverse side effects.
As the Parkinson's disease progresses, people taking dopamine-boosting drugs for a long time can experience distressing side effects. Some other side effects of drugs for Parkinson's disease can be compulsive behaviours. Although only a small number of people experience this, it can leave a devastating impact on the person affected and on those around them.
What sort of symptoms do they show?
They show all the classic symptoms associated with Parkinson's disease. They have very reduced locomotor activity. They tend to have quite rigid posture.
And do they eventually die of it?
With the MPTP lesion, it's not progressive. Yeah. This is the major difference to the situation in man. Remain responsive to...
Doesn't get any worse, no.
So
they actually seem quite happy.
They do. We think it's a very good model because the animals are actually able to maintain themselves without any drug treatment.
Giving MPTP to marmosets is classed in law as a severe procedure. The animals are initially quite sick and have to be nursed by their carers. They have to be hand-fed and groomed. But after they recover, they are able to live independently again.
So these little guys will actually manage quite well. They feed, eat, look after themselves, but have enough motor deficits for us to be able to measure the increases when we treat them.
So in fact they don't suffer anywhere near as much as humans?
No, that's very true.
And then you give them some drugs to see, or test new compounds to see if...
Yes, the animals are very responsive to dopaminergic drugs, and this is obviously the main treatment for Parkinson's disease. And also we're looking at drugs that can be given in combination with dopamine agonists or L-DOPA to reduce the side effects.
What do you think is going to be the end product of your research?
Right,
as far as there is ever an end.
Yes, I think we will always continue with with improving the therapeutic strategies. There has been a great concentration on looking at movement, but Parkinson's disease is a much bigger syndrome than that. It isn't just about movement. There are a lot of other symptoms that need to be addressed, and we would really like to.
Well, I know some of those. And would you go from these animals to monkeys, or this goes from here to humans? Is it?
If we've seen good results in the marmoset, this is a primate model that is sufficient for things to be taken forward into man. And certainly, a lot of the research we have done in the past, particularly with drugs like COMT inhibitors, entacapone and tolcapone, these were almost taken directly into the clinic on findings that we presented.
Yeah. So then you're straight into small numbers of human trials. Oh, well, I'll be volunteering.
Oh, that's excellent.
We've got
excellent.
One volunteer.
Great.
One of the things that was impressive was the cleanliness and the care of the animals in the laboratory. And the animals obviously very happy and content, easily handled, not at all frightened. And I hope that they will soon be able to prevent the progression of the disease. And for people like me, that would be an enormous encouragement.